Hi all. Today we are going to discuss one of the method of oxygen administration, that is nasal catheter. How, with the help of nasal catheter, how we can administer oxygen or how we have to insert the nasal catheter. So all those points we are going to discuss in this portion. So in this picture you can see nasal catheter, it has inserted into the nose. Okay, so till where it has inserted, that and all you can see in the picture. So nasal catheters are used less frequently nowadays. Why? Because it is involving inserting of oxygen nasal catheter into the nose up to the nasopharynx. It needs to be changed at least every 8 hourly and inserted into the other nostril. It is also painful and mainly it can cause trauma. If the person, those are inserting, if they are using little bit force also, it can cause trauma to the or injury to mucous membrane. So that is why, that is the reason that we are less frequently using the nasal catheter nowadays. Next, what are the general instructions that has to be followed while administering oxygen through nasal catheter? So oxygen, it has to be treated as a drug. That this point already we discussed previously. Every parts of the apparatus should be clean to prevent the infection. So why? Because if it is not clean, if for example dust, it was there in the oxygen cylinder and somehow it has entered into the tube. So while applying or while supplementing the oxygen, surely it will be going to the lungs. Then again, the condition will be worsening. So to avoid that, every part of the apparatus should be cleaned properly. Change the nasal catheter at least every 8 hourly or more often to prevent blockage of the nasal catheter by mucus plug. So we have to change, if we are administering oxygen by nasal catheter, that catheter has to be changed every 8 hourly. Otherwise, it will be blocking the nasal catheter by mucus plug. So to avoid or to prevent that blockage, we have to change every 8 hourly. When the oxygen therapy is to be discontinued, it should be done gradually. So I already mentioned in the previous classes, like if the oxygen administration or the oxygen concentration is medium to high level, if you are discontinuing the supply, surely the patient will not be able to cope up with the situation. So what we have to do in the sense, we should slowly reduce the concentration. Then when it comes to low level concentration, you can discontinue. And you have to check the patient's condition also. Pay attention to conditions that can interfere with the flow of oxygen from the source to the patient. So after administering, just after applying the catheter or face mask, whatever it is, we cannot leave the patient. We have to check the flow of oxygen to the patient. We should check. So what all we have to check, in the sense, we can check the tubings, whether it is working or not, whether the flow rate is correct or not, any loose connection or any faulty humidifying apparatus, if water is not there, then surely that will be causing dryness of mucous membrane. So we have to pay an attention to the patient while we are administering oxygen. Keep always a spare oxygen cylinder in close vicinity. So if the oxygen has over from the cylinder, if the cylinder has got emptied, then surely we have to administer again. So for that, we should keep a spare oxygen cylinder. Watch the patients receiving oxygen therapy continuously to detect early signs of oxygen toxicity. So we have words like whatever it is, if it is excess, surely it will create or it will be dangerous. So here also, while receiving the oxygen therapy, we should watch patient continuously if any signs or symptoms we can see because of oxygen toxicity. So toxicity, it can occur due to over oxygenation. So we should prevent that. For that only, a clean, close observation should be there. Since the oxygen support combustion, fire precaution has to be taken when oxygen is on flow. So I have mentioned already what all should be the precautions, what precautions has to be taken when we are administering oxygen. So these are the general instructions has to be followed during oxygen administration. Next, we'll go for the procedure. So before going to do the procedure, we should prepare the patient. That is very important. So how we can prepare it? So what are the things? Check the name, bed number, and other identification marks of the patient. Check the diagnosis and need of the oxygen therapy. So this is very important, like we should check the name. We can check by file or we have to call. So through any of these way, we have to check the patient's name, bed number should be checked, identification marks if anything is there, then diagnosis and what is the need of oxygen therapy, why we are administering for this patient, particular patient. So this has to be checked properly, and after that you have to check the physician's order or doctor's order for initiating the treatment, and you have to check in that flow rate, dosage, concentration, which method we have to use. That all will be there in the doctor's prescription, so that you have to check it properly. Then assess the patient for any clinical anoxia and patient's vital signs, breathing pattern carefully before starting the therapy. Explain the need of the oxygen therapy and the sequence of the procedure. So you have to explain the whole procedure and what is the purpose of this procedure. Everything has to be clearly stated to the patient. Through that, we can gain the patient confidence and we can clearly reduce the fear and anxiety of the patient. Keep the patient in a correct position, Fowler's position you can give, then you can start doing the procedure. So what are the articles will be needed for this procedure? So first of all, oxygen cylinder. So oxygen cylinder, it can be with the stand, otherwise central supply of oxygen will be there with the flow meter, humidifier and a connecting tube. This is to deliver the oxygen. And next is a tray containing nasal catheter. So nasal catheter is needed to deliver the oxygen. Water soluble lubricating jelly. So lubricating jelly is to lubricate the nasal catheter for easily inserting the catheter into the nostrils. Next is adhesive tape, that is to attach the nasal catheter after placing the nasal catheter into the nose. A bowl of water. So bowl of water is using to check the oxygen flow